Welcome to Cut Up. Cut Up is a program of the Ministry of Greater Evangelism World Crusade, a ministry set up by God Almighty over 45 years ago through His servant, Apostle G.D. Numberi of blessed memory, to preach the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ and to prepare people everywhere in the world to make heaven. This program shall be aired on this station same time next week.
Visit us here today. Amen. We pray that you will send forth your word to us.
Amen.
That whatever be the desire and the situation of our lives, may we have an encounter that will bring laughter, rejoicing,
amen,
and put a song in our mouth.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Can we shout a better amen?
Amen.
This is Greater Evangelism War Crusade. In Greater Evangelism War Crusade, we have a burden, and that burden is to prepare men and women for heaven. We don't teach men how to make money, we teach them how to make heaven.
Hallelujah.
So we want to encourage you that in this service today, you will open up your heart and encounter Him so that you will be prepared. So that when He comes, because He's coming very soon, you will be qualified to go with Him. I've titled the message I want to share with us this morning, An Encounter with the God of Mercy.
Hallelujah. The head of the talk, when I want talk this morning, now how you go feed meat with that God of mercy.
Our God is a merciful God.
Our God, now God of mercy.
When we talk about mercy, we are talking about, you know, if somebody has been under distress, you know, there is something that happens. Someone comes to alleviate your situation. Or you are in a situation that you are helpless, and someone comes to show you compassion and send you help.
When will they talk about to jam the God when go show you mercy? The thing when will they talk now? That mercy when go reach you, when you see yourself inside wahala, when be heavy load, when one finish you, when you don't look up, look down, nobody to help you, you see somebody come to you, come tell you, say, I go help you.
The Bible says that it is because of the mercies of God that we are not consumed.
But they tell us that because of the mercy when God they show us, now He make fire never burn us or anything swallow us.
We saw in the testimony Somebody was standing, two people, one just shifted and bullet landed. And in other places, the thing will pierce windscreen and it will not stop until it kills somebody. You can see that God has been showing us mercy. And today, he will yet show you mercy.
Amen.
In any situation you
Amen.
Are today,
Amen.
This is the God of mercy. The God that established this ministry. The God that set up the healing service. It's a God of mercy. And today, that mercy will reach you.
Oh, hallelujah! We did see the God when get the power to save us. The God when get the power to pity us and remove us from the thing when go fit kill us. We hear the testimony this morning. Two people, they stand for one place. And it be like, say, God, just tell one person, shift small. And as he shift small, in no day, bullets, I don't know where they come from. Bullets, when we don't know where they come from, carry power, come land for that place when they stand before. And at the same bullets, when we they hear, say for Lagos State, a woman just go visit the husband for hospital. They drive in her car, they go house. Bullet just look her throat, pass the windscreen of the motor, go jam her for throat, she dead there die. This one no fit kill our sister.
In the passage we read today, we find a story of a man that met the God of mercy.
Hallelujah. For the place when we read John chapter 5, 1 to 15, we see this man when jam the God of mercy.
We are told in verse 2 that in Jerusalem there was a pool called Bethesda. That is the Hebrew name for that pool. But the meaning of Bethesda is the house of mercy.
Hallelujah. For this place when we read, Bible they tell us here, say for inside Jerusalem, he get one pool. When they there, pool, we submit it won't be pool, where get water they gather. When they there, and for Hebrew language, they call them Bethesda. But the meaning of Bethesda for English language, now the house where mercy day.
So that means that is a place that people that have problems, challenges, people that cannot help themselves, when they come to that place, they will find help. They will find mercy.
Hallelujah. So the thing one mean be say, he get a place when God don't prepare, so that the people when carry heavy load, the people when get wahala, when not feel help themselves, if they reach there, God go feel save them. They go feel get mercy.
And so the Bible told us that in that place, we had a gathering of what the Bible called great multitude, large number of people. And they had one problem or the other. In fact, the Bible called them impotent people, sick folks. Some of them were crippled. Some of them were blind. Some of them were paralyzed. Some of them had internal heat. Some of them had high blood pressure. Some of them had high, you know, diabetes. Just name it.
Bible tells us that plenty people gather for that pool. And these people when gather for that pool, they be people when carry wahala. People when they sick. Some of them, they know they see, their eye blind. Some of them, they know they talk, their mouth closed. Some of them, they know they feel waka because their leg don't break. Some of them, they carry high blood pressure come. Some of them carry HIV come. Some of them carry TB come. Plenty of them with plenty, plenty sicknesses, all of them gather for that pool.
This is our house of mercy.
Hallelujah.
The basket of miracles.
They were all gathered there because they wanted an encounter.
Hallelujah. Jerusalem gets their own house of mercy. For greater evangelism, this one and him be our own house of mercy. Now the place when God don't pack blessing, full of inside baskets, so make we collect one by one.
So we, as we progress, the second thing we find there is that everyone that came into that place was looking for something.
As we then go on, you go see, say, all the people when gather for that pool, when come for that pool, all of them they wait for something. Their eye, they look for something.
They were waiting for the moving or stirring of the water.
Then they wait for the time when something go shake the water. Something go come make the water make it shake. Now that time that they wait for.
So, if you are to receive your mercy, you must come with what? Expectation. Expectation to receive. Everybody that came in there that wants to receive is waiting for one thing. He was waiting for what? The moving of the water.
So if you want to get mercy, you must carry the mind, say you go get them. You're inside your mind, you must believe, say you go get them as you they come. Because all of them, when they're there, they carry for mind, say they go get the thing when they define. When they define, make God show them mercy.
Man that receives from God are people that come to him with expectation.
Anybody when go get something from God, now the camp person or the camp people, when they come meet God, we say they go get the thing when they find.
Some people come into meetings like this, they go home with their testimony. Others come and they don't receive anything. Most times, the difference is how prepared. What is your expectation? If you hear some of the testimonies of people who come out here to, you know, to testify, they tell you that they made up their mind and say, God, today is my day. I will not go with this problem.
Some people, they come to this place and a testimony they go carry go back to their house. Other people, they come as they go back to their house. Now the problem when they carry come, now they go carry go back. Waiting be the thing when they happen. Waiting make these two kind of people make they not be the same. Waiting make they not be the same. Be say that person when carry testimony go carry fake say he go get something from God. The other person when not carry testimony go, he come say make him just come. And I make him carry wahala go back. But all the people when go believe say then go carry testimony go, God no go allow them go empty hand.
And as we go on in the message, we'll find that God was looking for that expectation. We're going to see it along the line. But the Bible said that they were waiting for the moving of the water.
The Bible, they tell us, that all of them, they wait to see the time when the water goes shake.
So that means if the water is not stirred, particularly by a divine agent, anything you do without water will produce no results.
So that one means, say, if that water never shake, and the power of God, now he will be the one to shake up. If the power of God never shake that water, even if he jumped there 7 times like Naaman, you will still carry your problem go.
So that means everybody there who really wants to receive a miracle must be very vigilant, must be with anticipation. That means, because as we find from that story, some of them were even living there. It was like, you know, some healing home. So that means that even when you are sleeping with one eye open,
open.
So immediately you hear the sound of water, you jump in to get your miracle.
Praise the Lord. So what did we see here? Because all of them went come there. All of them carry one mind, come, I go get something. And because of that, all of them open their eye. Then they shine their eye. They wait the time when that water go shake. That one shows say, even when they sleep, now one eye go close, the other one go they wait the time when the water go shake. That one they show us again say, plenty of them don't begin, they leave that place. That place they don't take and make house, and then they go back to their house. As we get them to, it gets some people when they get healing home.
No man knows when the angel will come. So you must be in readiness. Just like the Bible also admonishes us. We don't know when Jesus will come. We must always live with expectation. We must always live prepared. Because it can come in an hour that no man knows. And the Bible says that when the Son of Man shall come, shall he find faith on the earth?
So every time they wait. Every time their eye they shine to make sure say they no miss her. Because they no go, they no sabi the time when the angel go come. And I saw the Bible they tell us say when Jesus go come, he no go tell us. And the question be say, we they wait for him? We they wait for him? Because Bible they tell us say, they ask us questions say, when Jesus go come, he go see people when still get faith they wait.
Some of us in our services and even in this service, we go late to church. And it has become your habit. You don't know when the visitation will come. We had the testimony, the healing came when they were doing what? Singing. So some of you come, we have finished worship. And you must have missed your time. You must live your life that, you know, you must have expectation. Because God will meet men and women that have expectation.
Some of us, we don't take I'm saying the way our life dig. We know they come quick. They come late. We hear Elder Pastor that's in Jumbo. They give us the testimony of that miracle when they different. The time when the miracle happened to him. Now the time when they worship. And at the time his own angel can't touch him. When you come late, if he be said the angel or the power of God won't heal you, come that time when they worship. He go check you for church, he never see you. He go carry your blessing, give another person. And he go carry your wahala, go back.
Now let's look at the significance of the moving of the water.
Make we see this water when they shake. What did it mean?
You know the Bible uses a number of things as symbols, and water is one of the symbols that we use. One, for the word of God. He said you are clean because of the words you have had. And water is also used as one of the symbols of the Holy Spirit.
So we sabi say Bible they use so many things to show us the meaning of other things. Will they show you, for example, say the word of God or water, they show how the word of God they walk inside us. And he also they show how the Holy Spirit they walk inside us. He said, una don't clean because they don't wash una with the word of God.
In science, stagnant water does not have the ability to produce power.
Water, when no they shake, when just they there, bro. That water, no they get power. Power, no they come out from that kind of water. For science,
it's the same water, but the difference is that there must be emotion for it to be able to produce power.
Now the same water, but if power go come out of that water, something must push them hard before the power go come out.
So this water, we can represent it as the Word of God. We can represent it as the Holy Spirit. Yes, when you give your life to Christ, the Holy Spirit is in you. But the Holy Spirit in your life needs to be stirred up. You need to stir up your spirit to connect to the Spirit of God, to be able to receive from Him.
So, water, they show us how the Word of God they walk and how the Spirit of God they walk. Yes, the time when you repent and welcome Jesus Christ inside your life, the Spirit of God don't enter inside your life. But that Spirit of God, if we never wake him up, if we never shake him, make him stand up, he no go fit do anything inside your life.
The Word of God that we have, you need to activate it for it to produce result in your life.
The Word of God, when you don't hear, it could make you put life inside them. It could make you wake them up if you want them to bless you.
That's why we encourage you to read the Word of God prayerfully. Read it meditatively. By the time you activate it, it will produce result in you.
Now, it make with the tell you, they make you say, make you they read the Word of God with the whole of your mind. When you they read them, no read them like say you they read newspaper. As you they read them, they pray. Make blessing come out of the Word of God. And when you they read them like that, the power of God will wake up that word when you they read inside you. And power will come inside your life.
The same thing with the Holy Spirit. When you enter into an environment of worship, when you enter into a time of prayer wherein you are consuming it, is you create an atmosphere for the operations of the Holy Spirit in your life. We had the testimony, thank God. The song created an atmosphere. The Holy Spirit came down in His power. And that thing that doctors could not do in Nigeria, the Holy Spirit did it. Just simply, just came upon him. And it was like, he said, ice water, like shock. After three times, the matter was over. An atmosphere was created. And the Holy Spirit began to operate. We need to stir up our spiritual waters. You need to stir up your spiritual waters. Many of us, we are living and operating in a stagnant water. And we can't experience the power of God. We can't experience the grace of God.
Plenty of us, the water when we dey inside, now water when just keep quiet, water when life no dey. You supposed to make the water when you dey inside to wake up. And how you go make up to wake up? If you be say the time when we dey worship, or the time when you dey pray, you go come enter inside that worship or enter inside that prayer. Say that you don't prepare the place. You don't make the place fine for the Holy Spirit to enter and begin to bless and begin to wake up in power inside people. But when you don't dwell, it be like somebody will just enter somewhere and nothing they happen there. We hear them here this morning for that testimony, and we thank God. Now the time when worship they go on, nobody pray for them. He tell us here with him, oh my, say the thing come enter inside him, but they touch him, jin jin jin, like say now ice water, then take pour him. And so that when human being no fit do, that when all the best doctors for this our country no fit do, God no waste time, do him.
So we are told in that passage that when that water is dead, something happens. The Bible said that whose whosoever. I want you to note that word. He said, whosoever. That means anybody that steps in first to that stirred water. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter where you come from. It doesn't matter whether you know how to speak English or not. Whosoever. So that means that when you create an environment for the Spirit, it doesn't matter who you are, God will visit you.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Church, hallelujah. It sweeps me. Say, Bible, they tell me, say, when that water don't shake anybody, you know, as our papa they talk, I begin to say, protocol people know they're there. People know they're there to choose the person when they go push inside. Anybody, there nobody there to choose whether you come from your own town or you don't come from your own town, whether you like your face or you don't like your face. God will open them for anybody. I don't know the person when go be there anybody today, whether now you or me.
And the Bible says, step in. So even if you see the water moving. But you are on the shore and you did not step in, you won't get it. There are some of us who are in the service, we are worshiping. Some have stepped into the worship, others are spectators. You will watch and you will go home. It is those who step in when the water is moved, when the environment is created. It is those that step in that get the encounter.
This message shall be continued in the next episode, same time next week.
I know you have been blessed by this message. We are looking forward to hear your testimonies, and you can share it with us using the numbers on the screen and other means to reach us with your testimonies. God bless you. If you have just listened to this message and you have not given your life to Christ, I urge you to take that decision today. And if you're willing, I want to pray with you. Can you just close your eye wherever you are as we pray? Say with me, Lord Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for me. Today, I come unto you. I ask you to have mercy upon me and forgive me my sins. From today, I want to serve you from my heart. Be my Lord and my Savior. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. If you have just said this prayer, the Lord has transformed you. I pray that you join us in any of our services across the nations. And as you do, God will bless you.
Join us every last but one Sunday of every month for our monthly healing surveys, a service of worship, praises and music renditions by the Jubilee Voices Choir, a time of grace to receive salvation, healing, deliverance and mercy. Pastor Isaac V. Olori, the International Director of Greater Evangelism World Crusade and other anointed ministers of God, shall be there to minister God's word, real and undiluted, with power and glory. Venue Greater Evangelism World Headquarters along Port Harcourt International Airport Road, Rupoko, Port Hackett. Testimonies of miracles and deliverances abound. Make it a date with Jesus. He will heal you too. God bless you as you come. Are you hurting? Is your heart filled with pain, anger, and bitterness? Have you tied yourself up in the bondage of unforgiveness? Set yourself free today. Read the book, I Forgive For My Sake, written by Apostle Geoffrey D. Numberi. Get the load off your heart. Be clean and be free before God. Other books by Apostle Numberi and Pastor Dr. Mrs. N. E. Numberi. Digging Deep, A Man and a Vision, The Eagle Christian, Word Kill It, Word Make It Alive, and other books, magazines, DVDs, and audio CDs. For inquiries, please call 080-334-07909, 080-331-26028, or visit Greater Evangelism Bookshop, No. 1 Club Road by Station Buster, Port Hackett, and other leading bookstores. Email greaterheadquarters@yahoo.com.
Over my head, over my head, I had a music.
Thanks for watching. If you've been touched by this broadcast, please contact us today. Contact was brought to you by Greater Evangelism World Crusade.